Everybody told me, no, don't you do through with that because you can't climb make it, don't even much. I said, I guarantee he's the one who gave me the wood, so I'm going to make something out of it.
If they've heard me say anything about using each fiddle, it's because
you had them all
chromatic.
Right. So, ladies and gentlemen, it turned out good, didn't it? Everybody said, you don't need to be fooling with that. You can't play the way
you know.
I said, well, Ray gave me this, what to make it out of, the wood and the fretboard.
The,
I They play ragtime anyway.
That's just got a good
Yeah, give her a kiss now.
Watch that dulcimer back there.
What dog?
Oh, okay.
She's going to get closer than she's off in. Are you ready, David? You ready?
Go ahead. Ray, tell us about how, when and how you got started with dulcimers. You didn't grow up with dulcimers, right?
No, I didn't know anything about dulcimers until we was getting ready to retire, about 1988 or so, and we decided we'd try camping, and we went to the mountains and we liked it. We decided we'd try it again, and went back, and we was driving out an old road and come to a old general store. It's just more or less for, you know, people to see. And we got out and went in there. And that guy had things standing up beside the door with strings on it. And I like anything with strings on it. So I went in, looked at it. I thought, I don't want nothing like that. I'm not interested. But I went on and asked him what it was. He told me. He said, it's a dulcimer. We'd been in Pigeon Forge and, what's the name of that other town up there?
Gatlinburg.
Gatlinburg's got a dulcimer shop. And I guess they've had it for a long time. And I walked right by it and didn't know what I was looking at. But we went out there, and I got to see one up close. And make a long story short, he finally told me, said, you pick it up and look at it if you want to. I strummed it a little bit, and I had never heard anything sound like that. So I put it down. We looked over the store and we started to leave, and I went back and asked him again what it was. He said, that's a dulcimer. And I thought, well, I don't want a dulcimer. So I started out and I reached down and I plucked the strings again. I turned around and walked back and asked him again what the name of it was. And I said, I gotta have one. Where can I find one? He said, you can't. Well, I had to have one then, but he said, I said, I got to have one. Where can I get one? You can't. If you want one, you got to go home and make it. So he handed me a yardstick, crooked yardstick, and rolled me off a piece of brown paper, laid it on the counter, told me to go get the dulcimer and mark it. Draw everything off on it. And I pretty well did. Enough that I could make one if I knew how. So I come home, got me a big piece of big oak board and a piece of elbow board, which is the one of my music wood. And I kind of figured out what I was supposed to do. Except when I got through, the piece of wood was solid. And I knew you couldn't play with a solid piece of wood. So I went downstairs and got me a router and routed all that wood out and left it real thin where I could have an empty box in there. I made that dulcimer. Didn't know how to tune it, didn't know how to play it, didn't know what I was doing with it. So that fall, I guess, we was at Diana singing, and a good friend of ours, Bill Alexander and Mabel, came in, their camper, and they hollered at me. He says, "Come here a minute." Bill did. I went over there. He brought that dulcimer to the door, showed it to me, and I looked at him. I said, "Bill, did you get any book on that?" He didn't know. I wouldn't look at his instrument. So he gave me his book, and I took it back to my camper, found out how to tune it, and I tuned it, and got to kind of where I could play one little tune on it, and went back, took it over and showed it to Bill, and took his book back. Now that was the beginning of my dulcimer experience. So that wasn't good. I had to have another one. And I made it, and I had to have another one. And I was getting a little better at it, I had to have another one. And I wound up with, I don't know, quite a few over 300.
Wow.
And I enjoyed every one of them, enjoyed making them, and enjoyed seeing people get them that learned how to play them. So,
how'd you get involved with the folks from Athens playing dulcimers, or get them started? Because there was no club in Athens, right?
That's a big story, and a good one from the start to the end. We had heard about the Dulcimer Club, so we went to Tullahoma and started one in Tullahoma. We found out Paul Powell made dulcimers. We went up there and got Paul Powell Dulcimer Club started. And then I heard about the one in Birmingham. So we went to the one in Birmingham. And a few years after that, we was down there, and Grady Swanner and his wife came up through there, and they was looking for, we had a chair for sale. So they come up looking at that chair, and I was sitting over there playing my dulcimer. And he asked me, said, "What are you doing?" "I'm making music." "Well, what are you making music on?" And I told him, and they hung around there for a long time. And then they left. That's the last of them. So here come Jerry and Louise, and they'd ask somebody around the corner where they could find somebody that played the dulcimer. And they told them about me. And they come around there, and I think they stayed most of the evening. And he bought one down there, best I recall. And also, before we got away from him, I think he bought one or two of mine. So him and Louise started playing. Neither one of them didn't play a bit. The Swanners didn't play. And so we worked around down there, and we went to Birmingham again, to Tannehill. And coming back, we stopped at Decatur. And we had the Grady, Janice, and
Roger,
the Todds was there. We come on to Decatur.
Mm-hmm.
Huntsville. Monsanto Mountain. Or...
And now we come to Decatur there, and Roger joins us, and Pat, and
Neil.
Roger's brother.
Yeah, Pat and Neil was that way.
Yeah.
We were staying at Port Mallard in that campground.
Yeah, at Port Mallard. But Roger played good. She played a little bit. And when we left there, she was jumping up and down and playing that dulcimer like her.
How long had you been playing dulcimer as Roger at that time?
Oh, at that time, I was just starting. I'd go around to the dulcimer festival, see Ray and Bob Barnes, Bill Russ, some of the older people, you know, Hollis Long, some older people. I started about 95, somewhere. Mm. I always looked up to the guys that had been playing longer than me, because I learned a lot from him watching Ray. I always thought he was one of the best dulcimer players anywhere.
So Jerry Louise got started around
2003. Yeah. 2003. They come over there, and then I think they left with, you had a Max Padden or something that you bought there.
Mm-hmm. And then we got two from you.
And two from us. And we left there and went to Decatur, and left there and went to between there.
Huntsville,
that.
Up on the mountain?
No.
Or J.P. Coleman?
No. Mm-hmm. The one.
Joe Wheeler.
Oh.
Okay. We went to Joe Wheeler, and I think they all came up there, and we had a ball.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
What we didn't have a dulcimer, had one when they left. So, and they've took over and really pushed that thing, and they've got good at it. They're some of the best dulcimer players I know of around Athens. And I guess when y'all started, it wasn't any, was it?
Only person we know was Roger could play in Athens.
Roger.
It took me 2 months to find him after we met you. And when we found him, he told us you were on the mountain camping, so we came over and camped out.
Yeah, I actually put y'all on the Ray's
name.
Right.
Roger told us about you.
I said, well, y'all had seen him at J.P. Cole.
Yeah.
Right. Then you found me and said, boy, I said, well, one of the best mountain dulcimer players I know is camping right now on Monsanto.
Packed up and went. Been bugging him ever since.
So when the Athens Club got started, Ray helped you all get started, and how was it?
Well, no, we learned how to play with Ray
from
the shade trees and camping.
Yeah.
And then the city let us use the rec center free. They're looking for a music group. So Roger was our teacher to start with. When Ray went, Roger and Ray's the two main ones that got us going.
So it was Roger, and then who all do you remember was involved early on in Athens?
Jerry Louise, Ray and Homer, Grady and Janice, and
Charlie. And Billy.
Billy Craig, the bass player. And first time we met, I don't know, probably had 35, 40 people there, you know. But that was the core of the ones that played together, camped together. So, but it just kept expanding and getting better.
And we had Dolphine to keep us under control.
Oh, yeah.
We weren't playing. We
making bean
on,
soup.
We depended Dolphine. On her.
Yes. I remember she cooked that big pot of beans up there on the mountain. And relish. Put relish in them after we put them in our bowls. It was so good. I do that all the time now.
Yeah, when we weren't learning from Ray, Dolphine was spoiling us. So that's how it went.
Well, we put up. Well, I guess kind of got acquainted with Athens, and that was Swanners and the Todds, and Birmingham is about the start of the Athens dulcimer.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And they didn't know a thing about playing. And we move around. Roger and I was the only ones that could, you know, play a few tunes. And I wasn't very good at it then. But they took over and they done passed me. So we've got a bunch of good players around and in Athens and Florence.
Decatur and Huntsville.
Got a few in Huntsville left, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, that's great. I appreciate it.
But it's been a blessing for us, and we've enjoyed it. We wouldn't take nothing for the friends we've made in Alabama, Mississippi. And I say that because that's every time we went anywhere, our camper would head south into Alabama. And we didn't think about going anywhere else. We'd go down there because we know we had friends there. We knew we had people to play with.
That's great. Anything you want to add, Jerry or Roger?
I've enjoyed it. And I learned most of what little I know about playing the dulcimer by watching Ray and several others, you know. I used to go to the Florence Festival, Tullahoma. They used to have a lot of festivals, bigger festivals than what they are now. But I learned just watching the other guys, the older guys.
Well, I think that's why we all learn to play is watching somebody else. I know I had somebody that I watched and helped me. If it hadn't been for them to start with, I doubt if I'd ever, you know, got where I could play very well. But I'd made somebody play better than I could, and I would stick with them till I got to where I thought I could knew their tunes.
Of course, David, now we never met anybody that could play better than Ray could, so I don't know who he's talking about.
You, Roger? It'd
be hard to find anybody.
I hadn't found him.
No.
So.
Even if he had steal him. Yeah, Jerry stole him. Dumped him on his back, didn't he?
But David, one thing too. The best dulcimer CD that's ever been made, and I'm clearing this up right now for the world, the one's called Nashville Dulcimers. My buddy here, Ray Hunley, is the dulcimer player on that. He is the dulcimer, the only one on there, right, Ray?
Right.
Right. So we always hear these rumors that somebody else is playing it for a great tune.
Oh.
We know the truth. The truth is that Ray Hunley is the one playing that dulcimer. And so,
that
I think
tape,
it needs to be known to people. I mean,
that tape has got two guitars and a bass in it, so it's got.
They're great. Roger said the other day that was the best CD he's ever heard on dulcimers.
You know,
and I think the same thing.
You know what, Ray? Since you bought some away in that room in there, and he didn't find them until he was running through, finding looking what was in there, and he found them. So I think you need to get them, each one.
No, he give us each one.
A CD, yeah.
Oh, I thought you meant a dulcimer. Well, you found out. We already got
your hopes up. We didn't even know we had them.
Oh, yeah, well, you got them.
We've got them. We've got them, Dauphine. And plus, you know, we made that tape of Ray and the Athens album, family album. Have you got one of those? Where he sat and talked and played his top 30 songs in my kitchen. Have you got one of those? Yeah. That's one of the best ones ever. Roger made one, too, but whose computer was that blew up trying to run it off?
Williams.
No, Roger made one that blew up and we couldn't recover it.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So we'll get you and Delane and Jake. That's all.
Well, I tell you, I've got that one of mine on the thing in there now. and it's a DVD. And I like it. You had to, that was a good camera you was using.
I don't know where I stole that one from.
They brought it to college up there.
High school or whatever.
Anything else we want to add?
Today too, David. I mean, just coming up here and playing up here, the first Ray Hunley get together at his home, for us anyway. So it's been a great day for us.
Ray wants to come back 3 times next week, he said.
You got to do that pretty often now, 2 or 3 times a week.
We'll have her playing.
But another thing, David, when we first started playing the dulcimer, I asked Enos Yeager. He played on Hee Haw. So I asked Enos when I ran to him, I want to know who the 5 best dulcimer players are that live close to me so I can go learn from them. So the very first name he mentioned was Ray Hunley. The second one he mentioned was Roger Patterson, Delane Chaffin, and Bob Barnes, and Paul Blackburn. That's the 5 he mentioned, so we have got to know all those, and they all taught us a ton. So, but Enos has passed away, so we miss him.
Well, okay, there's 5 people.
Good players right there.
That I learned from.
Enos has been one of them.
Learned from him.
He didn't name himself, but he would have been one of the 5 or 6.
Yeah, he could have been.
But that's the truth.
I'm sticking to it.
He played a lot with Paul, but the others I have.
Well, I appreciate that. That's good information.
Thank you, David.
I was just glad we all had this today.
And it was good.
Mm-hmm. What
about
you?
Me
too.
Yeah, Rita.
Yeah,
got Rita
playing. It was a lot of fun.
Don, he's a nice fella because we were playing at our son-in-law.
Decision to come up here and be with us. We miss you folks. Something terrible. And I try not to even keep up with the schedule because when it's going on, I know just what y'all done.
And you're right in the middle of it too.
We enjoyed it and a
I'll go in there and get her out here in a minute. She's enjoying it. She talked about it all.
Since, yeah, we got to get her out.
Since Jerry said he was coming, she's been talking. She don't. She hadn't forgot that. She forgets who I am, but she hadn't forgot that. She'll say, now who all is coming with Jerry and Louise? I said, there's a whole bunch. Well, is so-and-so coming? So-and-so? She won't know what was his name. I can't even think of the name now. But this couple here.
Jerry
and Joyce.
Yeah. Larry. I've heard of Grady before, too.
I've
never
heard of Shady Grady, though. That's good.
Shady Grady.
I've heard that.
She said, is Shady coming?
Grady, if you hadn't heard of Grady, you hadn't been reading the newspapers and watching television.
She sure hadn't. She hadn't been.
Grady's all over.
Is that right?
Nationwide. We have relatives calling us, telling us about him. True, it is true, isn't it, Grady? Go ahead and be.
Thank you.
Ready, little girl.
Very good.
Thank you.
I just dawned on me. That was the first song we ever heard you play in person.
Is that right?
Over Tisha Mingo, when you played on stage. First one you played was Cowboy Waltz, and then Steel Guitar Riding, your second. You and Jake. That was 10 years ago.
About 10 years ago.
That's a J.P. Coleman, I mean, J.P. Coleman.
Back off of it and put a sponge under it inside there to tone it down a little bit, and it's a lot better. It's a lot better.
Yeah, they're loud.
Yeah, I've they're got, loud anyway.
I got a big sponge jammed in mine.
Heavy.
I got an old back that I played.
Yeah.
And D, tuned to D.
Okay. Okay.
Amazing Grace, Joyce. Can you sing it right? No, I hope you can get that.
He used to sing that all the time. There's only one that ever sings that, and Fallen Leaves. I heard him sing that too.
Sing any one of them. I was going to finish up with you singing.
Okay. Thank you.
show, and then